tell us a little bit about why you decided to join Avon, and what is it about skincare that just pulls you in and you want to learn more about skincare, and you became an expert actually in skincare?
Well, actually what brought me to Avon ties right in with why I'm so into skincare. So before I get into that, Avon, I've always known about Avon because, again, you know, Avon lady, and my mom always ordered things here and there throughout the years. So I was obviously familiar with the name enough, mostly just skin so soft, to be honest. I never really paid attention to anything else. But then something happened. Avon launched anew, the skincare brand anew. They launched that in 1992. And 1992 was probably 1 year after I started really hardcore doing skincare. Here's a funny thing. Don't ever think it's too late to start doing skincare and looking your best. It is not. It is never too late. It will have dramatic results on your face no matter what. So don't listen to people saying, oh, I'm just too old now. Why even bother? No, come on. You want to look your best, which makes you feel your best. So again, a year into using skincare and I was all over the map. I got started because good old Broadway, the department store, if you've ever heard of that, Broadway gave me my first credit card. Well, that started all the trouble. So there I was at the cosmetics counter and I'm seeing all these eye creams, face creams, night creams, day creams. You know what? To be honest, I didn't know what the heck any of that meant. But obviously I knew enough to say, well, eye cream, it must be for the eye. And I knew better than to stick it in my eye. So I got that. Well, I actually started using tons of skincare and all the big brands, all the big names that you might know, Clinique, Lancome, all of those different ones that were always at the department stores. I settled on Lancome. I liked the formulas. They were anti-aging. They were light and my skin absorbed them really well. Because again, when I tell you that I've tried almost every brand out there, I really have. Now, it's been a handful of years that I've really gone gung-ho trying other brands. But still, things come across, you know, my face, catch my attention. And I do still try things just to see. And I'm always led back to Avon. Main reason, Avon has the best skincare products on the market and the single most affordable prices for actual skincare that is anti-aging and helps with all the different things you may need. Skin tone, texture, fine lines, wrinkles, whatever it may be. So that's how I got into it. In 1992, anew was launched. It was just one thing, and I actually have it here to show you. It didn't look like this back then. So, the anew AHA, which is alpha hydroxy acid. So alpha hydroxy acid was launched. And when they launched this, it was kind of one of the biggest things to hit skincare around the globe, really. And Avon was the exclusive for alpha hydroxy acid, for a cream with alpha hydroxy acid. So what this did for Avon was it really put them on the map as a big time skincare company. This is what really launched it all. They always had great skin products. You know, just, I don't mean to diminish any of the products by any means, because they are still great and we still have lots of them, but they were a more basic little routine. More about cleanliness, which you do not want to forget. Always clean skin, you want to start with that. But they were great, you know, just little skin creams here and there. And again, they still have them, but nothing was really in the lineup of anti-aging, big time, high-end skincare. And this launched them, AHA. So there are seven types of AHAs. Oh my God, my dogs are going crazy over here. Used in products throughout skincare. There is a citric acid, which, you know, from citrus fruits, there's a glycolic acid, hydroxycaproic acid. It's like a royal jelly, and it comes from royal jelly, which might get touch a little bit on that. Royal jelly comes from bees. We'll get into that. There's other hydroxy acids that come from animal products, lactic acid, which probably everybody, you know, from lactose and carbohydrates, malic acid from fruits, and tartaric acid from grapes. So So again, these are great because AHA was the first all around skincare breakthrough that promoted collagen and blood flow. It really got the capillaries working in the skin, and it boosted collagen, which I also want to touch on. So you started to see instant improved fine lines and wrinkles diminishing. The appearance of those started to go away. So once again, anti-aging, it helped prevent acne breakouts. It would brighten your complexion overall and increase product absorption. So while it exfoliated and did all this for your skin, it was actually helping all the ingredients for anti-aging get deeper into the skin and have your skin hold it. So let me quickly jump to collagen just to tie it in with this. Collagen is basically the number one biggest protein in your body. And it's for bones, skin, it's just all around. It comes from a Greek word that means glue. So if you think about it, try to think of collagen as like the glue that holds the body all together. So again, it makes up, as far as proteins in your body, collagen makes up 1/3 of all the proteins in your body. So if you're boosting collagen, which we're gonna get into when I show you a couple products, and you might've heard, we have the collagen powder that you can add to drinks. Blanca has that in her coffee right now. So again, tying it into alpha hydroxy acid, because alpha hydroxy acid helped boost the body's collagen, because it's the body produces its own collagen. So collagen is great for the skin because it gives it, if you want to think about it, gives it a bounce back effect. You are going to get, you know, when you smile, crinkle your eyes, whatever thing wrinkles up, it gives it that bounce back effect so that you can always look smooth, look your best, look your brightest. And again, it is in the body. Normally, it is the biggest protein in your body. So just think about that, especially since we're going to talk about natural things. All right. So Avon hit the market, AHA. So funny, they brought it back just a handful of years ago. They had had it forever, and then they built on that line. They built on AHA. It was such a popular thing. It had such excellent results. They skyrocketed. Well, that was the first thing I got my hands on from Avon, and I was all over it, day and night. And it had dramatic results. Now, again, I was only 21. And I had only been a year into skincare. And what's funny is my friends, my exact same age, kind of made fun of me. I don't understand why you use all these eye creams. What is all these creams? What are you doing? Why are you so, I talked about AHA and how Avon came out with it. And oh my gosh, it's so much more affordable than all these ridiculous brands at the department store. And they would kind of laugh. And then they would all go, well, there's nothing wrong with your skin. You're only 21, what are you doing? Well, I'm certainly not 21 now. And boy, have they all changed their tune. Because a lot of them will look at me and say, damn, you still have the same looking skin you did then. Now, I don't. I mean, I've got the wrinkles. It's up here. I've got it. But again, a lot of it is having that healthy glow, just that fresh, almost looking more awake than you are, which is hopefully right now I may look more awake than I am. So again, that's what launched Avon. That's what got me into it. And I was a customer of Avon for skincare ever since then. Really got into new. I phased out all those other ones, all those expensive brands, and I never went back to them. I stayed with Avon anew. Then they came out with all the different anew lines over time until we got to the point of having a full line. And then certain lines kind of targeted. We used to be trained to think of it like age categories. But don't always think about it as age categories, because although that's a great generalization, you know someone's age and you say, well, this might be the best product line for you. But you might hear them say they have a specific concern, and that might lead you to a specific product that sort of targets that concern. So again, we do try to make it as easy as we can, but there's a lot of skincare out there. There's a lot to know, so it does get confusing. So before I get into specific products that I'm using, I'm just going to say, if anybody is watching live and has questions about certain products, or if you see me talk about one that I'm using or how I'm using it, because I'm going to put stuff on. I took a shower, sort of did my hair. I did not put anything on except one thing, and I forgot to bring it out here to show you, but it's in the Hydrafusion line, and it's the little tiny tube, and I can't think of the name right off the bat. But it's for eyes, and it's for puffiness and dark circles. And I did that only because Blanca kept me up so late last night that I had to try to get the puffiness out of my eyes. So that's the only thing I put on after I got out of the shower, just to try to get this to go down a little bit and have me look a little more awake than I am. All right. Something I started doing, kind of funny, you're gonna laugh at this. After LG came into our lives with Avon, and I started learning more specifically about Korean beauty and why Korean beauty was the number one thing around the globe, which I had always heard that, never really paid attention to it. Again, I was Avon, I was a new, don't take my new because you know what, I'll chop your hands off, that kind of thing. Very protective. So my first reaction, and all of you that are reps might have had these reactions. Oh God, here comes a new company and they're kind of in charge of us. I mean, they are, they own us. Now they're bringing us new things. Great, they're gonna ruin our skincare lines. Now what, now there's more stuff coming our way. I was very much like that. I worried, don't get me wrong. I worried thinking, what is this new company gonna do? I have to say, they put specific brands that they already owned into my hands. And I used to be a person that wouldn't try anything new. When I found my thing, I stuck to it. So when Avon built on there anew and built it up and got these lines, oh my gosh, I was so happy. They had anew for everything. I was loving it. And then the very first wave of change came. They started revamping their formulas, revamping the packages, revamping the naming. And I about lost my marbles on them about this. How could they do that to me? Now remember, I was not a rep then, I was just a customer. How could they do that? So as it phased out and it was in the outlets that we used to have, the little sale books, I would stock up. Don't ask me to try something new. How dare you? I'm not gonna try anything new, ruin my face. Are you kidding? After becoming a rep, very interesting, all of that changed. Mostly because as a rep, we got some great deals to try some really awesome products. Well, then I ventured a little more and then I realized something. It is always good to have, you probably will never have as much as I have, so don't worry, but it's always good to have at least almost two full regimens. It doesn't have to be two full regimens, but think of it this way. Almost two different things that you can do because you want to give your face a little bit of a change up. Because like everything, it doesn't build up a tolerance to products where the products no longer work. You might hear that in skincare. It's not true. However, once your skin has really taken in a product and it has done its job, it may not seem to you that it's really having the effect anymore. Not because it's not working, but because your skin has actually been nourished to the point where it doesn't need it as much. So you're not seeing massive change. That's why it's good to change things up. Different products do different things and offer the skin different anti-aging components that it needs. So change it up a little. So again, not necessarily two full regimens, but if you can get to that point, that's great. I don't even say I have a regimen anymore per se, or two or three. I must have like one of every product or two of every product. They are all over my sink counter and God help me, I just kind of grab them and I do change it up. I do at least 1 week of a set of products exactly the same, then I'll switch it up. So again, as we get new products, those go right into the mix. I'm instantly on them. And when new ones come in, I usually stop most of everything else because I want to be able to really say, honestly, what is this doing for me? I can tell you, like, I'll just show you real quick. We have our What's New, and it talks about Pharm RX coming out, and it talks about what it's going to do. And that's great. Will it do all those things for me? Maybe not, because maybe my skin doesn't need all those. However, don't think it's not doing those, because if my skin already has enough of a certain component that it needs, maybe collagen, maybe, I don't know, the alpha hydroxy acid, maybe hyaluronic acid, which we'll get into as well. Maybe my skin has all that it can do with those, and that's great, but that doesn't mean the product's not working. It's offering other things. So again, now I'll tell you, Korean beauty, I can't even talk now, we're gonna go downhill from here. Korean beauty brought us something interesting. So in the Korean way of doing things in skincare, they actually cleanse twice. Let me tell you, when I heard that, I was like, oh, how dare you think you're gonna do that, and I'm not gonna do that, and you think you're gonna be better than me? Oh, no, no, no. So with everything that we had, I had to think of how I can work this in, and I loved it because I'm seeing major effects from it. So one of the lines that we have is Dr. Belmure. That's what one of the, sorry, if I turn it, Dr. Belmure. This is a line, I've seen the name, never thought twice about it, would have never known LG company owned it. It kind of floored me. Again, I always thought of LG as the electronics company. So to know that they were skincare, I mean, when they bought Avon, I thought, oh, they want to diversify. No, they were already diversified. They had a massive skincare component to their company. So the Dr. Belmure Foaming Cleanser, really interesting. I love this one because it's so light. So I will tell you what I did in the shower this morning, and this is how I get ready. First, so I get all wet, get my hair all wet, but the first is wash my face with this one, okay? Just scrub it up, and down here, now I have a shirt on, so I can't go as low as I do, but I get all the way. Don't forget the décolleté, because you can be an absolutely beautiful woman, but you don't want to be attached to a turkey neck, just saying. It happens to all of us. I can see that this big pouch right here of mine is gonna become my turkey. Anyway, so that one, that's how I use it. That's my first wash. Great, skin is prepped, I'm in the shower. Then the hair, so I shampoo, then I put conditioner in. While the conditioner is up there, I will, so this is kind of funny, this is what I did today. I don't do this every day. One of the things that I don't do every day is the hair mask. It comes in a little gold pot from our Elastine line, from LG, they brought it to us. I don't have that here, but anyway, if Blanca has one to show. So anyway, it says hair mask. So I did that today, but I don't always do it. So I put the conditioner in that goes with the shampoo, scrubbed up the body. Then again, not every day. So the hair mask is not every day, it's every few days. Then here we go with the collagen. This is our Anu in the Equinox line. There it is.
There it is.
Here, Propolythera from Elastine. Mm-hmm. Little golden pot of honey. Clinical collagen booster. This is the micro needling polisher. Now, I love to have a facial scrub. I love when we can have a facial scrub that you can use every day. And I know usually they say, that's too much for the skin. And it usually is. So if you get a scrub, you need to really read it and see, does it say okay for every day? Most of them will say use it a couple times a week. I leave 2 days in between each use. So I used it today. I will not use it again until Tuesday. I'll leave Sunday and Monday. And the reason I do that is this one is so good. I only need a little bit. Put it in the palm of my hand. I get my face nice and wet with really warm water. Again, sometimes that's the controversy. They say don't use too warm because the hotter the water is, the more drying it is on the skin. But this micro needling polisher is excellent as an exfoliator. It seriously takes off all the dead skin cells on your face. So I just rub it all over. I even get it on my fingers. And then I just do this. And I just scrub, scrub, scrub. And I do circular motions all around. Then I'll do this even under my eyebrows here, especially here, because I'm trying, you know, the crow's feet. Mine have turned into ostrich feet. So I need help here. So I do it all, rinse it off. Now, again, if this is a day that I'm gonna do this and my hair mask, I rinse that off and I rinse the conditioner out of my hair. So I know we're talking skincare, but you're gonna get a little hair stuff too. So I rinse the conditioner out of my hair, and I've already scrubbed up my body. So face first, face was the first thing, face and neck. Then shampoo. Conditioner, scrubbed up the body, rinsed off, collagen booster microneedling polish, rinsed the conditioner out, rinsed all that scrubbing off my face. Then I did the hair mask because I got a couple more things I was going to do. Since I had to shave this morning, now this is not an Avon product, so I didn't bring it, but I'll tell you. I use original Noxzema cream in a little jar. I use Noxzema as my shaving lotion. The reason is when I put it on my face, it deep cleanses the pores. It's an extra thing. So Avon, if you ever hear this, will you please copy the Noxzema type cream and come out with one? Thank you. All right, moving on. So I use Noxzema and then I go ahead and put it all on my face because it's a great facial product. So my goal was to always cleanse my face twice since, well, if the Koreans do it, how dare they? Fine, I will do it too. It's already started again. Noxzema is an extra cleanse, but it is, I'm using it as a shaving cream. So I shave up, then I rinse off. Then I didn't rinse the hair yet, leave the little hair mask in. Then for the final, and I know a lot of people don't like this, I do brush my teeth in the shower too. So at that point I brush my teeth. All right, and using Avon's toothpaste, I have it all, I've tried all of them, love them. Then comes the final. Now I don't necessarily use a new cleansing brush, takes a couple batteries and, oh, you won't really hear it, but a little vibration, kind of like an ultrasonic, and the little brushes just kind of pop off, you know, so they don't really spin, they just pop off. You can see it was still wet under there, yes. All right, this is great. And my final cleanse, so really my second, because the scrub doesn't count, that's not every day. I use the Rice Water Bright Cleansing Foaming Cleanser. I just like this one, and again, I'm still a bargain hunter. This is a big tube, okay? So that already got me. But that won't keep me. Excellent cleanser, excellent. And I've used all of Avon's cleansers. I like all of them, and they all do different things. This is a daily for me. Now, yes, I might use something else later down the road, just again, to change it up when I wanna change something in the routine to give my skin a little bit of a break and introduce something new. But this is my final, right here. Not every day on this, although this brush is gentle enough to do every day. And if you're doing this, you are getting a nice, good, deep cleanse. You are really cleansing those pores. So again, you rub it all over, circular motions. I go all the way down right here, you know, the whole thing over it. Again, you just don't need to push hard because that's the trick here. Don't push hard, but just brush it over. And remember, the skin can take a little bit because you want to kind of activate all those blood cells and all the capillaries, really get it going because that's what's going to get your product into your skin. So that's what I did in the shower right there. That was getting going. Then rinse that off, rinse that stuff out of my hair. Then I got out of the shower, did my hair. Then I start going with products. Well, here's the thing. I didn't put anything on, so I will actually do all my skincare with all of you. As I said, I didn't put anything on this morning other than our little Hydrafusion eye for like puffiness, because woo, looking awful this morning, looking tired. So I wanted to kind of tone that down a little bit before I get going. So with me, I use a lot of product, and I know tons and tons of reps, not just our customers, but reps. Always watch, you know who's a great one is Janine, that does those videos for us and talks about products and shows us everything that's coming. She talks about her own regimen. And I know a lot of people still think, how can she put all of that on? She seriously puts all of that on. Yes, I have all of the serums. I have everything. Again, I don't use every single thing every single day. But I do kind of have a routine, a consistency. I will at least do 7 days of one exact same routine, then change it up. So today I will talk about a few products that I'm not using, but I do use them because I'm getting to the end of a week of doing one particular set. So here's an interesting one. And I know a question came up from none other than one of Blanca's daughters. So this is the first thing I would do after getting out of the shower, drying off, and I'm gonna start skincare. It's the little, we're going back to collagen boosting, the little Anu clinical in the Isonox line, the collagen booster, the little, there go the nails, the little pink capsules. So it's interesting, if you've used these and you've wondered, there's barely anything in there, how am I supposed to get this all over my face? The trick is, it is designed as an ampoule. And that's actually a key word to think about. Ampoules are just, I will figure out how to explain this to you guys and I'll maybe post it back on the comments of this video because I had an esthetician actually explain this to me once before and I can't remember it, I'm sorry. But ampoules are very different skincare. They're very concentrated, so you don't wanna use a lot. So it's kind of funny. One person did tell me, yeah, there's just not enough in there. So I was using two to get it all over. Not going to kill you. And that's great. It's a great product. So fine. But you don't need to. Here's how I do it. It is not the right way. It's not the wrong way. It's just my way. So let me twist off the little end piece. So if you've tried it, like I say, you're going to probably feel like there's nothing on my face or there's not enough to smooth it around. Trust me, there is. You'd be very surprised. It is designed to go on so fast and dry so fast that you kind of don't really feel it there. But it has a dramatic effect. I've seen major effects from this little tiny thing. So I usually do, now I'm watching it in the camera to see if I can do it. I usually do a little bit up there. It's probably a little too much. I usually do a little line there and a little line here. Sorry about the shadow on this side. My ring light is off to the side instead of in front of me because I don't have a proper setup. All right, then I squeeze out the rest in my hand. Not much, there's not much. Because I just put a little line, a little dab up there. Here's how I've been using serums lately. And I have seen much better effect than the way I used to put on serums. Just way, way better for me. Again, not the right way, not the wrong way. The only wrong way to do skincare is to not do skincare. Just remember that. So now the rest is on my hand. I smooth it all around. And again, it feels like there's nothing there. Then I do my cheeks and I'm not rubbing too hard, but I am getting it in. I go down, then I come up here and I just try to do a little bit on both hands to get that. I rub it around, get it on here. And I can actually still feel it on my hands. It's very light, but I can feel it. So I'll do little bits, just rub it. Honestly, it feels like there's nothing there, but that's the way it's supposed to be. Now I know it's there because now I'm used to this and I can tell. So I rubbed it in. There you go. Great. Now, the next one I use, Dr. Belmure is a favorite line of mine. So I love this one. It is also, this is our Cica peptide. It is also designed to be an ampoule. So do not use a lot of this. I take, let's hopefully I can show you. There's this much in the dropper. You can see where it's up to here. I'll only use about half of that. So let me see if I can get that into the palm of my hand. There we go. I didn't use it all. And once again, smooth it around. Best thing about that, this one goes on and it should dry pretty darn quick because the skin just absorbs it. Again, designed as an ampoule. It is a very fast absorption, super intense. So you don't need a lot. You will definitely be wasting it if you're using too much because the skin can only take so much at one time. There you go. And my skin is actually like dry, it's done. But the reason I go behind this one, if you think about it, we've always been trained, go with the thinnest formula first. As a rule, that is how it would be done because it's harder to put a thicker consistency substance on your face and then get a thinner one over it to where it really gets into the skin because that thicker one is there. So again, good rule of thumb. For me, because this little pill, this little collagen bubble is such a drier formula, again, just personal for me, I think this one helps push the other one in even more because it's there and this one is much more liquidy. It's much more thin. So that's how I do that one. Now I'm not done with serums, so no joke. Now would be if I was on a week where I was using our Neutralize anti-pollution, by the way, if you really want to just stick to one, you're like, whoa, Jim, I can't do all this. Totally, totally acceptable. I will take it. No, I'm kidding. That's totally fine. Not everyone can do all this. And it isn't as time consuming as you may think, because I do it pretty quick. It's just slower right now because I'm explaining it and doing a heck of a lot of talking, as you can see. So I do use the anti-pollution. I'm not doing them this week, but I love the anti-pollution. I saw such dramatic results with our Neutralize line. Honestly, they best never get rid of that line unless they convince me that whatever comes in after it does even more than that does. Otherwise, I will fly to New York and be at their doorstep and be like, oh no, let's have a talk. All right, so today, what I've been using this week, vitamin C serum. Again, brightening and glow and vitamin C is just healthy for the skin. It helps, it's actually good for the immune system, you know, vitamin C. Great, again, for the skin. So it helps too with the various components of pollution, not as much as neutralize, but it will help with that. So again, a little bit of brightening, but then my one of my real favorites, the hyaluronic acid, 1.5% in our hydrofusion line. Hyaluronic acid. So let me touch on that real quick. Hyaluronic acid is also a natural substance in your body. It is something that the body actually creates. But here's something interesting about hyaluronic acid. Let me tell you seven different things that you might be shocked it does for your body. We all know, obviously, it promotes healthier, more supple skin. The reason is hydration. It holds in water. And you know, they say the body is made up of just, you know, water. It keeps things moving. So it keeps your skin flexible, allows your skin to, once again, bounce back, you know, working in conjunction with the collagen. It just keeps your skin able to handle what we're going to put it through during the day. Stress, pollution, crinkling our eyes, laugh lines, whatever it may be. So healthier, supple skin. You may not even know this. Hyaluronic acid can help speed wound healing. So if you have a scrape, a cut, whatever, hyaluronic acid is in your body. It's what helps speed healing. So think about this. Crinkles and creases in the skin are actually, you could say like a wound. Think of it like it's creasing in the skin where the skin folds. Hyaluronic acid is helping heal that, which helps diminish the wrinkles in those fine lines, which means it's gonna work with the collagen. And what is it gonna work with? Our Dr. Bell Muir line, which has cica, which is great for healing. So again, all these things, you may wonder, well, why do I need all of them? Maybe you don't, but they all work in conjunction with each other. They're all bringing a little bit more to the table, a little bit more to your skin. So it's great. So here's how I get away with using all the serums I do at one time. I will put, let's see if I can actually do this on the camera where you can see it. I will put, just a little tiny, not a full pump of it, but a little like that. Okay, very tiny, not a full pump. It's probably like a half a pump. And then I will combine that with about a half a pump of the hyaluronic acid, maybe a little more, because I'm all about hydration with this one, because, you know, I'm outside with the animals and my skin can tend to be drier just because I'm out and about outside all the time. So again, I'll put that in. There we go. So you saw kind of two drops fall out of that. So it's kind of one big drop of vitamin C serum, two big drops of hyaluronic acid. And then I actually blend them together because the consistency is almost the same. But if you've used the hyaluronic acid serum, it's really liquidy. I'll call it runny. It's really thin. So again, it's almost drying in my hand, which is great. And then I just put it all over. Again, just giving that skin a little extra boost, especially around these ostrich feet next to my eyeballs. Go around my nose, everywhere. There we go. So it's not too much for the skin. I'm not packing on too much, and I'm loving it right now because when I do this right out of the shower, again, it's much faster. It doesn't take the time you think it may. I'm kind of sweating a little bit from the shower and I'm still a little bit damp, and you really should start with a dry, dry face. So having come on and do this live, I'm really starting with dry skin, which is the best way to do this. So I'm actually feeling good because it's going on better than normal. So again, went on great, already absorbed in. I'll just do a little bit more light rubbing just to get it in. And usually I go down across here. Again, don't forget that turkey neck. Gobble, gobble. Thanksgiving's gone. We don't want the turkey right now. All right, so we did all that. So if you think about it, if you can see, I mean, who knows? Let's see if I can get real close. It's not, well, in the light, I don't know. You can't really see detail with this camera. But my skin is not wet, it's not dripping, I don't have tons of stuff packed on. But yet, I've already done three serums per se. The Dr. Bell Muir Cica isn't really a serum. It is the ampule, and I did our collagen booster ampule. So two ampules, which are meant to be very light, very thin, very small amounts, they're very intense. And then two more serums on top of that. So I haven't even gotten to facial creams, whatever. Now, again, because usually I'm in the bathroom and I gotta let this kind of dry a little bit, I would start with I. So let me throw that in. Let's see if I have that. Did I bring it? Yes. So depending on what I'm doing with eyes, I will use two different eyes. So again, I told you I got out and I used the hydrofusion to diminish the puffiness. So sometimes I don't always need that. Sometimes I will, like I can tell when I really need to just have that extra boost. Otherwise, my eye regimen is usually one of two things, either the vitamin C, which I'm about to put on. And I know one rep actually had a question saying, mine looks kind of brown when it comes out. It does kind of look a little brownish tint, looks more like mustard than a bright yellow or bright orange. So again, just a little bit, and then I kind of go up and around just to get a little extra. And then I bring it out over here because I want those darn crow's feet to go away. Not a fan of crows. All right, let me do this side real quick. I don't want to be at half wattage here. So we'll do it. These yellow nails are killing me. My God, the things I do for Blanca. All right, so I put it on. Again, I'm loving this. It is absorbing in so fast because my skin is perfectly dry while I'm doing this time. So that's usually a first. And then I'll go with face. So I noticed I did an eye. Now I'm going to go back to face. So when I finish with eye, I'm still using, I'm going to bump it up because my age is about to change. We won't talk about that right now. I'm still using the Anew Reversalist, my favorite eye treatment so far. I love everything we have. You notice, I mean, vitamin C, I'm already using that. But again, I usually do two eye treatments when I'm doing this. Sometimes I will use, instead of the vitamin C, so next week, that'll be this one. I'm using the Belief, because I actually like the Belief eye treatment. I actually love this one. You know, I'm really impressed with the Belief product. So thank you, LG, for bringing these to us. I mean, I realize I could have got it at Sephora, but no, I'm not going to Sephora. I don't think so. All right, so that was the first eye. So now let me put on my first facial cream. So again, this week, I have them all, guys, even that Mission, I call it Luxurive, like luxury. I guess it's Lux Rev. Anyway, I have that one, the real expensive line. I do have that one. I'm almost at the end of that one. So I will be picking that one up to finish it off next week when I change some things up. But for this week, I've been using the Dr. Belmure. And this is the Cica Recovery Cream. Now, out of the two creams, basically, we have the Hydro line, the Cica Hydro Cream, which is extra boosting in moisture. This is the Cica Recovery Cream. Personal, this is just personal, I tend to like the other one better, the Hydro Cream. And the cap is a little bit lighter blue. Again, just personal for me. The formula is a little thinner, a little bit. This one is a little bit thicker, but I do love them both. And once I try a product, I will go full on. So that's why I always buy the full size products. I want to try them. And again, to see what they're going to do. Both of them have had excellent effects on my skin. Hydration, healing again, helping with those fine lines and wrinkles. So again, either one. So this is really just for me to recommend, would be just personal preference. Do you like this one's a little bit of a thicker formula. So again, I use the little spatulas that come with it. And you'll see this is how much I put on there. Kind of a big glob, you think about it. But then watch what I'm doing with it. So again, I'm gonna put it in my hand. And then I just kind of wipe off the little spatula. And I have another little spatula because I like these so much when I finish the other jar. I saved a little spatula to use in my Belief because Belief didn't give us a spatula. All right, so now I can close it up. In the old days, I used to put a little dab here, a little dab here, a little dab here, and then one, two. So two, and then I would rub them in. Well, now I don't do that because I want to get a nice thin layer, but I want full coverage and I want to be able to use more products. So once it's there, I do the same thing all over the hands. And I even get it up to the fingertips because I'm going to use everything of my hand to get it on. So all around, by doing that, I pretty much covered my whole face. And then I can get some down. Now you start to see a little bit of a glow because this one goes on a little bit more wet, so to speak. It is a thicker formula. So I'm just I always give everything a little extra rub in to really get it going. I want the blood flow to be really going and sucking in all of this product. Because I am buying it just to look pretty. Yes, I am. All right. So here we go. Rub it in. Wow, I'm loving this. So like almost absorbed all the way in. So that's the key with dry face. Okay. I guess Avon wasn't fooling us when they said start with a nice dry face, because I'm always a little extra sweaty when I get out of the shower. So I had enough time to really have my face dry. All right, so that's that one. So that, again, I just did the Dr. Belmuir. And again, you might notice that we always say rule of thumb, thinner formula to thicker formula. And most of the time, that is the way I follow it. But again, a lot of it depends on how I like them to go on and what I'm doing for my skin. So it is personal preference. So I've done that. Now you might think, well, Jim, do you really need anything else? Well, yes, I do, because I do want my big time anti-aging eye cream. So now I'll go back to this, because remember I started with the vitamin C. I'll put a little of this. Usually I have a mirror in front of me, so it's a little bit harder to do this. We'll just pat this in. And I go around the eye, up here, next to the eyebrow. Bring it out. Again, I want the lines over here to diminish. And don't get me wrong now, I do all of this, but once a month I do treat myself. I've mentioned this when Blanca and I are live on our other lives. I do actually treat myself once a month to getting a facial, which is usually just a microdermabrasion, a professional spa microdermabrasion. One of my friend's daughters owns her own spa in Chino Hills. I'll give her a little plug. It's a Face Logic. So if you ever want to go there, let me know, because you know she'll give you the introductory price. Anyway, I do that because I want an extra. I want really deep. Obviously, we have a lot of exfoliation products. So she's even said all the time, she noticed over last year, because here I was at home, working from home, getting fatter and fatter, eating myself to death. But I was taking care of my skin. So when she was able to open back up and I went in for facials again, she actually said, hey, your lines here, what are you doing on them? So I just showed her the products I'm using. And she's like, wow. She goes, they do work, because she actually saw the crow's feet lessening. And I was, you know what? That was good enough for me. For her to say it, I was like, all right, I'm good. All right, let me do this eye. Because again, I don't want to have one eye like puffy and one eye not. So I'll just quickly pat it down all around and go out. All right. So if you think about it, since I did start the morning with something on my eyes, I actually have three eye products on. Hydrafusion eye treatment for the puffiness. I did the vitamin C because I want to be bright-eyed for the rest of the day, because Blanca did not give me enough time to sleep. And then, of course, anti-aging, because heaven forbid, I am tired of getting older. Okay, so now I'm going to finish it up with, and again, I already used a whole Belief Aqua Bomb. So now I am at the tail end of Belief Moisturizing Balm. And again, just personal preference. I like the Aqua Bomb more than I like the Moisturizing Balm. Personal preference. I saw both of them give me the same results. Great hydration, skin bouncing back, just great anti-aging. But again, hydration, really good key of what they're doing for me. So anti-aging with hydration, which is boosting all the anti-aging products, all the serums, it just helps everything flow better. I just like the Aqua Bomb because the formula is a little bit thinner, and I tend to like those thinner ones going on. Again, just personal preference. So if you were to recommend to somebody, or they're asking you, well, gee, what do they do that's different? Would I need both? No, if they get both, great. They would not need to use both at the same time. You can tell them that. Maybe the thicker formula, maybe you recommend thicker formulas maybe at night, because you're gonna go to sleep and that's when all the natural rejuvenation of the body takes place when you're asleep. So it's gonna really suck that stuff in. But again, you're not going out, you're going to sleep. So if you got tons of stuff packed on your face, you're not gonna really care. So again, personal preference, I just tend to like the Aqua Balm better than this one. And personal preference on the Dr. Belmuir, I like the Cica Hydro cream over the recovery cream. Again, just because of the consistency and what I prefer. So on my next little spatula, I'm actually taking about that much. You might even say, damn, Jim, that's a lot. It's not. Remember, I'm going to be rubbing it on my hands, so a little bit is going to remain on my hands. You think I'd have the hands of an infant, but I don't. But does help, because I put it on the outside. All right, rub it all in, put it on. And notice I just kind of touch it, because I'm just getting the product off of my hands and fingers onto the face. Then just rub it in a little. And believe me, I really do go way quicker than this, guys. I can actually shower, shave, get ready, and be out the door quicker than you'd even think. Honestly, I think I could really do it if I tried. In maybe 30 minutes. I know you're thinking, whoa, seriously? Yeah, I go that fast, which is why, you know, I'm not really giving time in between each product for them to really dry and put the next one on, which is the absolute top of the line preferred way to do it. But hey, sometimes we just don't have that time, but my face needs it all, so it's gonna get it all. All right, put it on. Ooh, I'm liking this, it's absorbing in. I'm already getting a little bit of that nice glow, but I don't like a lot of the wet, too shiny look. That's just my own preference. Now, if I'm gonna go somewhere and I'm gonna be out and about, one of the products I may use instead of the two creams that I used, if I'm gonna be out, so I'm gonna need SPF. Might use one of my day creams, not both of those that I just showed you. So I wouldn't necessarily do two and then a third. One of these, and again, more likely the Hydro Dr. Belmure or the Aqua Bomb, and then maybe one of the new day creams, whatever line I happen to be using at that time with SPF. Since obviously it's been a year since I've really been going out and about, what I've been sticking to is the Hydrofusion with the SPF 50. We have that nice little fat tube. I love that one because when I am working in the yard, then the sun is beating on me. So I do need the SPF. So I'll only use one of those, or maybe neither of those, put all my serums that I need. I want those, I want all that extra anti-aging. And then the Hydrofusion is an excellent line. That has an SPF 50, so I'll use that as my day cream. And then I'm protected when I'm outside with the animals, I'm in the sun and raking chicken poop all day. So, you know, there you go. All right, so that's pretty much it. Now, if I was gonna go out on the town, you know, my tuxedo or Blanca in her evening gown and we're gonna go out, then I might actually finish myself personally with either Magix, because I like more of a matte finish, more of a dried matte finish. So I'll put that on. Plus it actually keeps the shine because I sweat really easy. So this helps it make my skin look like it's not sweating at all. And I've actually had compliments when I'm wearing that. People don't realize it's on. So again, just something to think about. All right, so that's what I do. I'm done with my skincare. There is still stuff on my hands, so I usually rub it in, just give my hands an extra boost. Why not? Skin is prepped. I feel good. I can feel it all on. It's great, but it's not heavy. You'd think it would be heavy after all that. It's not. So now one of the things that we really want to talk about, we have CBD coming out. CBD line is getting boosted. We will maybe do another special live on that or a little video on that. But let's talk about PharmRx since we're talking about skincare. I can tell you that I am like crawling out of my skin wanting to get my hands on this, wishing I already had it. So talking to a customer, let's take it from that standpoint. What's the best things about this? You probably already heard some of this. These are all natural products. And when we say that, it's not just that they're all natural products, because there's a lot of other products that can go into this, a lot of other components that are still natural. But Avon went through the trouble of actually making sure that there are tons of ingredients not allowed to be in this formula at all, because those particular products, while maybe natural, are not the healthiest things for us. They are not sustainable and they're not clean. We want clean products. When we talk about clean products, it means clean, healthy alternatives, not overly processed type alternatives. We don't want to take something that might be natural but has to be so overly processed to get the ingredient, because you're kind of diminishing its properties, and that does change its properties. So again, there's a lot of, they talk about this, there's a lot of blacklisted ingredients they just won't do, but a lot of them are actually bad for us, like parabens. One of them that the word is terrible to say, phthalates, it's a, horrible. Who comes up with this crap? That's what I'm saying. All right. Jeez, can we just make these words easier to say? But again, lots of blacklisted products. So these are going to be great. We have two different creams coming out. There is the cooling. So the cooling hydration. One of the best things about this is, again, I will describe it consistencies, how I'm viewing it. It's not, I don't know this for sure because I haven't got it in my hand. But if you could look at the picture that's on the screen, we've got, let's take the green one. Again, cooling. So it's going to tone down the redness. I always have like a little bit of pink to my skin, but whatever. I like it. I'm going with it. So it'll tone down redness. So if you have a lot of redness and you don't like it, this is going to help keep the skin cool, calm, but seriously boost the hydration. The next one is a nourishing moisture. So again, all about hydration, that moisture, and it has all the ingredients you need to seriously nourish that skin. And once again, both of these creams, all natural. All natural. Yes, they have preservatives. You see percentages up there? The thing is, even the preservatives that are in these creams, the preservatives are natural and they need to be there to make sure that the other ingredients don't go bad. These are all plant-based. These are all plant, like look at the left side of your screen. They call it super greens, Brussels sprouts, broccoli. What do we have down? It was green tea. Green tea is great for, again, waking up the skin, giving it fresh, like you're really just like glowing alive, awake and fresh. So again, all of these things are going in. These are all plant-based. So think about it. We've got to have something in there to keep them from going bad. Otherwise, you will have to use it fast, which means you'll be globbing it all over, and that's not how we want it. Also, these jars, now this is my favorite, because again, I'm a bargain hunter. Don't get me wrong here. I may have a lot of skincare, but I'm a bargain hunter. That's why I became a rep. I wanted to have my hands on everything new once I made that change over from not trying new stuff. I wanted to have everything new right when it came out, the soonest I could get it, and I wanted the cheapest price I could possibly get it for. So these two are coming out. Think of this Dr. Belmiore jar, or even the Belief full-size jar. These jars are twice this. They're twice. It is twice the amount of product, yet the same affordable price for our Anew lines, or even the Dr. Belmiore, or even the Belief. In the same price category, but you're getting twice. So if you're really having a hard time convincing certain customers to really get into skincare and take care of themselves, this line is going to come out. It's going to start with four products. I think maybe they'll expand it, maybe not. Here's the other two. So there's two creams. Do they have to have both? No. But for these kind of prices, maybe they go for it. Then on this page, you'll see we have an eye cream, then we have a serum. So if you want to set somebody up with just a basic skincare, the best they can get, maybe even just market it as the best bang for their buck because of the size of the product. All glass jars, which glass jars are a big thing for me. I would love when they're in glass jars. Just a big thing. I like it. And glass is one of the best, most recyclable products. So again, thinking about the different markets you could be in. Somebody seriously worried about environment or sustainability or all natural products, or people that are vegetarian or vegan. These are vegan formulas. So once again, not just no animal byproducts. And when I say that because we talked about collagen, we talked about hyaluronic acid. These are natural in our bodies, also in animals' bodies, not that we extract it from them. But again, just saying that. But these products in PharmRx are absolutely plant-based, all natural, nothing to do with animals whatsoever. So for a vegan person that's really worried about that, perfect lineup for them. And because they are all natural, all plant-based, excellent products for anyone with even the most sensitive skin. You are not going to get reactions from these products. And here's a key. If you even have slight sensitivity to your skin, because maybe you haven't used so many thousands of products throughout the years like I have, so your skin's not used to having a change up or not used to a regular regimen, you may view your skin reacting and think the product's not working right or you're allergic to it. It's not the case. Give everything a good solid 3 days. And what I mean by that is get to the fourth day of using it and see if you saw anything that you perceived as a reaction from a new product. By that fourth day, has it started to go away? Because again, remember, you're giving your skin new stuff to work with. So it could, and quite frankly, for a lot of people might have a little bit of reaction. They're not used to having that on their face. And that's why you want to encourage them also to really cleanse properly, because the better they've cleansed, the better these products are going to go on and not clog up pores, not actually cause any kind of breakouts. And most of our products are all hypoallergenic anyway, so they're not going to clog pores. They are not going to cause any kind of acne. But that's what people are usually worried about with new products, with trying anything. But this, all natural. The packaging on it, recycled paper, even down to the ink. If I'm not mistaken, did they say they were using ink out of seaweed? Like kelp, was it? So again, even the ink on the packaging, everything, all natural, recyclable. This is a product that for the biggest warriors of vegan, environment, sustainability, green and clean, this is them. There is no reason they shouldn't be using these. And the fact that they are going to get twice as much product in one jar under the same pricing as our other ones. How can you go wrong? I can't wait to get my hands on this simply because I know what's in it and I cannot wait. And one of them is that serum. And the biggest ingredient there, if I say it right, bakuchiol. So again, if you watch Janine's videos, ooh, she was all over it. But this bakuchiol, you know, once she started talking about it, trust me, I started looking that stuff up. It isn't anything new, but it is, well, it's definitely new to us as an ingredient for skincare here in Avon, but it's not new and it has been used before. But in skincare, for us now, we have a full line of all natural plant-based skincare that is anti-aging. That's the biggest key. It's not just about hydration and nourishing the skin. These are anti-aging products. These are high-end skin products. The bakuchiol itself is a retinol equivalent. Retinol is fantastic for the skin. That is a fantastic ingredient because it hardcore gets rid of fine lines, wrinkles. And I say it gets rid of because it does. It gets rid of them. Smooth texture, smooth tone, everything. But retinol can backfire on a person if they don't use it right. You can't use retinol and be in the sun. It has a photosensitivity. So let's say one of your things is different skin tone, or maybe you have spots you'd like to even your whole face out. Then you use that and go out in the sun. Well, those dark spots are going to be worse, or your skin could start getting dark spot reactions because of the retinol. Again, not, it's a great product, but you have to make sure, my recommendation for retinol would be at night, and absolutely cleanse your skin thoroughly in the morning, because you don't want any residual when you're going to go out, especially if you're going to be hit with the sun. So again, bakuchiol, 100% retinol equivalent, same properties, does the same things as retinol with the same intensity, and it's all natural, plant-based, and has no photosensitivity. So that serum, day or night, and you do not have to worry. Now, how often can we say that? Because we've had a lot of great products in the past, and there were a few that Avon strictly said, the use, nighttime only, do not use them during the day. We even had reps that were like, well, I still used it during the day because it worked so well. They were using during the day and would put big time SPF all over their face because they just wanted that particular property it was doing for anti-aging. They wanted it on their face day and night. I never took that risk and did the SPF because I tend to be out in the sun normally more than that. So I did those products just at night. But bakuchiol, oh my God. Yeah, not thinking twice. That's going to be one I have in my hands all the time. This is a big one, guys. This is a big one. So I highly recommend. Please get it in your hands. I know you hear this all the time, and I know a lot of reps, you're not in the same position as other reps. You can't afford even yourself to buy all these products all at once. I totally get that. You're not a skincare junkie like I am. That is my drug of choice, skincare. So you can see I'm addicted to it. But seriously, if nothing else, get yourself this little kit you see. It's in the What's New. Get that one. It gives you a mini version of all of them. Get yourself that and try it. And while you're using those, maybe buy one of the full size. Again, even just for yourself, so that you can tell other people about it. They will see how good your skin looks. And you can tell them, hey, I'm using it and I love the way my skin, you are going to love the way your skin looks and feels. There won't be a question in my mind that that's not going to happen. So do it, do yourself a favor. Look your best and it will make you feel your best. You will be so happy. This is going to be the product. And again, more affordable, more product for the money. So if nothing else, get yourself that little kit where it has all four in a little kit, just so that you're taking care of yourself and trying these new products. You will love them. How can you have an all natural, super extra clean, again, clean, none of those ingredients that may be natural, but they're not as clean and healthy for us? No, this is all clean and all natural, green products, sustainable, excellent anti-aging properties. That's why I can't wait. I am like foaming at the mouth wanting to get my hands on these. Something I've always said when I've talked about skincare, if you don't think Avon is a leader, take LG out of the mix for this for right now. If you don't think that Avon is a leader in skincare, let me prove it to you. I've done this time and time again. Every time Avon has come out with one of those breakthrough products, you know, or a breakthrough formula just created and just tested and they come out, we've had those throughout the years. I'm telling you, as soon as it gets announced, you will see other companies don't think they did it first. They will come out with something with almost a very similar name, like almost the same. Sometimes they will take a product they already have, change up the bottle so it looks like whatever we're doing as a packaging. And then they'll put it on the shelf because those other big names, they just have bigger manufacturing plants and they just have it, you know, it's just high-end corporate. They can rush things to the shelf fast. Whereas ours gets researched, developed, launched, as you see, because I don't even have this in my hands and I'm going crazy for it. And then ours starts to come out and starts to get in our hands. So it's different. They want to try to get ahead and pretend they're the first or just compete with Avon. Now think about that. Over the years, I've seen the brand Clinique. Clinique has rushed things out to the shelf or simply changed the naming on one of their products they already had to match a brand new breakthrough product coming out from Avon. Do they have an equivalent product? No, they don't. Ours was the breakthrough. Theirs doesn't even have the ingredient, but they've altered the look, they've altered the name, and it's on their shelf before ours gets into our customers' hands. The reason I mentioned this to you, Estee Lauder has done the same thing. When we've come out with super high-end serums, Estee Lauder has rushed a serum to the shelf, a serum they've had for years. Change the name, change the bottle. Now it looks like ours and sounds like ours. It is not ours. They can't fool me. I wasn't born yesterday. Oh my God, I was not born yesterday, I'm old. Anyway, so I'm telling you, PharmRx, has another company already seen what we're doing and wants to try to compete? They have, guys, of all brands, Neutrogena, no joke. I just saw it in Costco. Neutrogena has, and on the package it even says, double the size, just like PharmRx. The bottle's shape and look, almost like what PharmRx is coming out. What PharmRx talks about, the hydration, we saw those two creams, hydration and nourishing. Oh, wow. Their packaging says hydration and nourishing. I don't know who the hell they think they're fooling, but they're not fooling me. Just telling you. So again, once again, these other big names are not the leaders. So when you talk about Avon's products and talk about this skincare, and even the ones coming from LG, have confidence in them. Don't back down to other people that may say, well, I use such and such. And you can say, well, that's great, but I assure you, we have more affordable and better anti-aging products. Let me show you. And then if you need help, send a message through our group and say, hey, Jim, I have this customer and they use XYZ. What should I tell them to use and try from ours? And you know what? We'll help you set up. We'll find out what their concerns are, what products they're using, and we'll give them what our equivalent is. Trust me, ours is usually the one, but we'll help you with that. But just be confident when you talk about our products. They are anti-aging. They are top of the line skincare. Worldwide, they would be considered top of the line. Again, why do you think LG wanted to buy Avon so bad? They saw an opportunity in twofold. They saw an opportunity to get their hands on a new to add to their massive skincare lineup. And they saw a way to market their skincare products they already have that they know are winners through Avon, through us. And I'm loving it. Again, at first I was like, how dare they? No. Now I'm loving it. I'm loving all of it.
Thank you so much, Jim. You know what? I love your passion. Oh my gosh. You know, I'm thinking of all the things that I want to get, you know. Thank you for your time this morning. Thank you for giving us all your knowledge on all these skincares. I mean, my God, I don't know how all that fits in here. You're on mute. I wish I was as knowledgeable as you. And you know what? We can be if we put the effort into it, because remember, we want to be consultants, not just order takers. You know, if we know a little bit more about the skincare lines that Avon carries, if we know a little bit more about the products, if we know a little bit more about our customers, we're going to be better representative, better consultants, and be very successful in this business. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you, guys.